Today, we're in downtown LA and are visiting a vintage and antique architectural salvage store called Old Good Things. We are going to be checking out antique items such as home decor, furniture, and structural elements, so stay tuned. Architectural salvage is when building materials, fixtures, or accessories are salvaged from buildings that are being demolished, renovated, or dismantled. It includes doors, windows, and anything you can think of that's pretty much part of a building. These materials are then reused and reinstalled in other spaces. In 2004, the store opened in LA, but it's one of five locations. The original opened in 1995 at the Chelsea Flea Market in New York. I was talking to somebody from the store, and they said much of their inventory is from the late 1800s to pre and post depression era. One thing the store does that I found was interesting is repurpose antique and vintage materials into new items like mirror frames and panels. I'll show those later in the video, but I've always seen these kind of stores on other YouTube channels like Lone Fox, so I've been dying to check one out. So I found this one on Yelp, and when I did, I was very excited. In this section, I found plenty of outdoor items, including gates and cast iron patio furniture. I one day dream of having a cozy Victorian style cottage with like a garden and gorgeous patio furniture. So this is a happy place in my brain. Perhaps it would look something like this little cottage right here. These are those panels that I mentioned previously. There's just so many of all these different colors, and they made these specifically out of tin. The person that worked at the store told me that after World War II, this tin wasn't really produced much anymore, so now there's an abundance everywhere. So that's what you're seeing right here. There are about three full walls of these industrial and incandescent cage lights. I like all the different variations in them, and they all have such really pretty and subtle patina on them. Throughout the video, you'll notice a lot of movie and TV production items like stage lights and reels. I think it's cool how different stores have items unique to their location. So this store being in Los Angeles, you're gonna get a lot of, you know, Hollywood productions. If you're enjoying our exploration so far, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more adventures to come. The prices in this store are pretty up there. I think the location contributes greatly to that markup. What I've learned about antique and vintage stores in LA is that they're frequented by movie and TV productions for set props and stuff. So I imagine that is another factor, and not to mention the high wealth in the area. However, I also try to remind myself that in stores like these, you're also paying for the work of the individuals who went out, you know, in the community and got these items, you know, their labor and the upkeep to run their businesses and the high real estate in this area. So I figure many of these items are one of a kind, and not everyone wants to go hunting for items through, you know, estate sales or thrift stores. But that being said, some of the items in here are my rent and whole paychecks, so it's just window shopping in here for me. I love candles and sconces, so I am in heaven in here for that reason. I'm always on the hunt for them at estate sales or thrift stores, but so far, they've been really hard to come by. One of these days, I'll buy myself a nice pair that are perfect for me, and I'm willing to, you know, splurge a little on them. This binder holds a lot of the bigger items that are stored at the store's warehouse, or at least I thought so. I asked about the binder and was told it was many years old and that those items are no longer available, but it had such beautiful stained glass and front door gates in it, so I was blown away there. These busts are salvaged from the 1912 Vanderbilt Hotel in New York. I'll put a link in the description box about the history of the hotel if you're interested in that. I love hardware, and I think paying attention to the details when decorating really pulls the looks together and gives that decade, you know, you're trying to accomplish. One thing in particular I'm dying to find is an early 1900s soap dispenser like this. They manufacture new ones in the style, but I really want to find an antique one. I thought this was such a fun and unique store. If you're ever in LA or in the area, I highly recommend checking it out. I just found out that they have an online catalog that you can browse through all the cool things they have, as well as a blog, so I will link those in the description. If you enjoyed exploring and embracing the charm of the past with me, please subscribe and give the videos a thumbs up. See you next time, friends, and thank you for watching.